wehi ki te mana, i runga i te marae o te rā. Nō reira nau mai, haere mai, haere mai rā.
Please be seated. Ina mana, ina reo, ina hui wha. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Council Members, Members of the University, Special Guests, Graduands, Families and Friends. I extend a warm welcome to this, the second autumn graduation ceremony for 2012 of the University of Auckland. This week, the university is bestowing a total of 7,048 qualifications on some 6,862 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Business and Economics. A total of 489 in person, plus a further 220 in absentia. As Chancellor, I am privileged to preside at graduation once more. The twice-yearly cycle of graduation ceremonies makes them no less significant for the university and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first and only time. Graduation is always a festive event, rich in history, pomp and colour, but with some endearing contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our enviable mix of cultures and ethnicities is evident in the variety of dress and adornments worn by some of our graduates. Today is one of celebration, hard-earned and well-deserved, by you, the graduands and diplomates, on your academic feats, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you in good times and in bad, and who are here to rejoice in your success. The university, represented by the council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many professional staff who direct proceedings with unerring precision, takes equal satisfaction in your hugely significant day. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. The qualifications bestowed on you today will always serve you well in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a fulfilling career or in leading to further challenging study, or simply for your own personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's world of constant and often bewildering change, you can never afford to stop learning and honing your skills and capabilities. So do keep in mind our ever-expanding range of postgraduate opportunities. The critically important role of major research-led universities, such as the University of Auckland, in modern life is not always understood. Our cutting-edge research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social development, never more so than in these globally uncertain economic times. Universities such as ours equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for careers not yet imagined. The University of Auckland's aspirations for the period ahead and our responses to an increasingly constrained funding environment are comprehensive and demanding. They are taking shape in our draft strategic plan for 2013 to 2020, and I encourage you to peruse this wide-ranging document on our website and let us have your feedback. I urge you as alumni of New Zealand's leading university always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. This at a time when our country's universities receive the lowest income per student in the developed world. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create full and satisfying lives for all New Zealanders. That's enough from me on the challenges currently facing universities. For today is unquestionably your day. I warmly congratulate each and every one of you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in May 2012. We welcome as our speaker this afternoon Karen Vautier. She is a research economist who has held important positions in the public and private sectors, as well as academia and charitable organisations. After gaining a BA degree, Ms. Vautier began her career on the research staff of the New Zealand Institute of Economic Research. She also started a 35-year relationship with this university in various roles, which included teaching competition law and policy at master's and undergraduate levels. She spent 5 years as a member of the Commerce Commission, and since 2002, she has been a lay member of the High Court under the Commerce Act. She has had extensive governance experience on major corporate boards. Ms. Vautier currently chairs the Auckland City Mission and the Musica Sacra Trust, as well as being a director of the Reserve Bank of New Zealand. In 1993, she was awarded a CMG for services to business and economics. Ms. Vautier.
Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Deputy Vice-Chancellors, Members of Council, Members of the University of Auckland, graduates, families and friends. Some of you may be thinking there's a contradiction in having an economist address you today, just when you were expecting this to be such a happy occasion. But don't be alarmed. This economist is not going to talk about sovereign debt crises in Europe, budget deficits, bond rates, exchange rates, or concerns about international growth prospects, except to say that these sleep-depriving economic and financial issues are greatly affecting the international environment in which today's graduates will pursue their careers. It's a fragile environment, fraught with constraints and much uncertainty, as well as increasing competitive pressures. So today's graduates will have little option but to wear the mantra of efficiency and effectiveness in everything they do, whatever and wherever their roles might be. Now we know that geographical boundaries no longer determine the matching of talent with opportunity. More than ever, we can expect a premium for international and multicultural perspectives, as well as a premium for creativity and problem-solving skills. That Fly Emirates ad actually grabs attention. Tomorrow rewards the curious, those who travel beyond the borders of convention, which leads me to my central theme, creating your own story. Those of you about to be capped have already embarked on your journey, and you can have real pride in the formal recognition at today's ceremony of the credentials you have attained across a wide range of disciplines in the Faculty of Business and Economics at the University of Auckland. This is clearly a milestone event and one that we are all here to celebrate, but just a stepping stone nonetheless. Your stories are yet to be created. Part of what we are celebrating is the opportunity you each now have to influence the future state and reputation of business, the opportunity to foster social and economic advancement. And we can only hope that this opportunity will not be squandered. Just think of how many individuals here and around the world who don't and won't have such an opportunity, who cannot even embark on a journey that rewards the curious. You are so fortunate to be surrounded today by a supportive faculty, family, and friends. You will always be indebted to them for the university education you have had. But they have really done no more than help pave the way for you to create your story. What they want for you more than anything is that you use this education to unleash whatever potential is within you. None of us knows on our graduation day what that potential might be. None of us knows the destinations we will reach in our journeys. Now, some aspects of my story have just been shared with you. Your stories have yet to be narrated. They will start with what's in your head, and they will end with what's in your head. One can only feel sympathy for the young doctor, Tertius Lydgate, who in that great and insightful 19th century novel, Middlemarch, bitterly reflected that this is what I am thinking of, and that is what I might have been thinking of. As to Dorothea Brooke, the central female character in Middlemarch, the author concluded that the effect of her spirit and everyday words and actions was incalculably diffusive. For the growing good of the world is partly dependent on unhistorical acts. Now, these words still resonate nearly 150 years after they were penned. However diffusive the effect might be, what you say and do day to day matters. How you deal with issues of trust, dignity, and justice matters. How you navigate risk, a conflict of interest, or dispute resolution matters. Unhistorical acts they may turn out to be, but you have been handed the baton, and like Dorothea, you will be paving the way for those who follow. Given the investment that has been made in your university education, we are entitled to expect that you will do your best to ensure that the sum of your everyday actions will add value and raise the average, that you will help others to realize their potential, and that you'll always be willing to interrogate your own thinking, bearing in mind what Lord Keynes wrote a century ago: the difficulty lies not in the new ideas, but in escaping from the old ones. We are also entitled to expect that in your head, you will know that professional and accountable accurately describe the everyday conduct that will anchor your story. Maintaining high levels of personal integrity matters. Your grades may be good, and your technical competence superb. But like a singer or violinist on this stage, something has to be added to distinguish the end result. Individual interpretation. It's the whole performance that counts, and it's the preparedness to continue to learn and to better that performance that counts more. Now, surely this audience would disagree with the young Tertius Lydgate in Middlemarch, for whom knowledge seemed a very superficial affair, easily mastered. And hopefully, today's graduands would disagree with Lydgate's view that judging from the conversation of his elders, he had apparently got already more knowledge than was necessary for mature life. Mind you, much of what clutters our airwaves and is available online is hardly necessary for mature life. When I consulted Wikipedia, just to remind myself of what was going on in the outside world in my graduation year, I found, amidst Beatlemania, Vietnam War protests, and the collapse of New Zealand's wool economy, that the World Cup trophy for soccer was stolen at a stamp exhibition in the UK. It was found under a hedge in southeast London by a male mixed breed collie dog named Pickles, who became a celebrity and died soon after when he choked on his lead chasing a cat. And by the way, the thief died of emphysema. Now, I must confess that the place of Pickles in the historical record of world events had escaped me. What must not escape today's graduates is the opportunity to make the story you create, wherever in the world you create it, truly worthy of the University of Auckland's historical record.
On your behalf, can I thank Ms. Baudier for some very interesting and wise and valuable observations and advice. This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within their faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Mrs. Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduate Diploma in Commerce, Benazir Shazia Ali. Regan Quinton Baddeley. Lily He. Luigi Yatindra Nadun Jamani. Yusman Ahmed Khan. Sharon Pratika Kumar. Melissa Erica Mendonca. Savashni Naidu. Tulsi Patel. Venushka Antonio Pereira. Amrita Prasad. Divya Vanessa Boniface Quadros. Aisling Ramona Ram. Tracy Marie Skumger. Sapna Sharma. Rahul Ravadeep Singh. Chantal Taylor. Manas tendon. Depisha Ben Yumaria. Chun Meng Ya. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce. Michael Olorunwaju Akinola Abraham. Angelo Albregina. Jeanette K. Adams. Adhikari Muriyanselagi Vikum Tarinda Adhikari. Omer Adil. Suhaib Jamil Afiz. Alani Afu. Elliot Wade Agate. Shane Anthony Eric Albert and a graduate diploma in commerce. Alzina Razia Ali. Richmond Fraser Allen. Lewis Allen Anderson. James John Angus. Shahad Ansari. Cherie Fleur Anna. Abhinav Arua. Mark Hassan Asapur Desfuli. Namita Mary Justin Austin. Faith Natini Babindra. Chan Hyun Beck. Soyun Beck. Win Jin Bei. Scott Lawrence Baker and a graduate diploma in commerce. Manish Balsara. Karan Tashishandra Bangira. Diksha Bansal. Meredith Chelsea Barrow. Daniel James Bowman. Kylie B. Tiffany Cheryl Crystal Bell. Senior Scholar Commerce, Paulina Billick. Calvin Andrew Benedict. Kelsey Ellen Benge. Nicholas John Lester Beansley. Gurleen Kaur Bhatia. Abhijay Bhattacharya. Harleen Bhatti and a graduate diploma in commerce. Michael David Bibby. Ian Richard Black. Yeah. Stephen Christian Blaise. Vanessa Margaret Bond. Oksana Borodina. Courtney Wallace Bald. Stephen Daniel Marvin Boyce. Paul Stephen Brock. Anthony Patrick Forbes Brown. Bridget Emily Bucknell Whaley. Georgia Kate Anna Burns. Anna Ellen Butcher. Carla Savatiera Jr. Caneda. Logan James Kaysen. Philippa Margaret Catherwood. Senior Scholar Commerce, Michelle Kavanagh. Lauren Elizabeth Chernohosky. Gye Hyun Che. Ashley Daniel Chan. Hong Chun Chan. Lim Wu Wenjiang Edwin Chan. Wai Hung Tong. Wei Hei Cha. Nichelle Avashek Chand and a graduate diploma in commerce. Chanel Vikash Chan. Li Wang Chang. Maninod Tansuk. Sobhip Cha. Jennifer Cha. Arik Chen. Danling Chen. Nanjun Chen. Ting Ting Chen. Sarah Tang Yun Chin. Ting Ting Chen. Yang Chen. Chen Ying Ting. Jenny Chung. Wai Lun Chung. Irene Ling Jin Chu. Sanjay Chiba. Lokman Chu. Ying Shuan Chnong. Sung Mung Choi. Yun Jin Choi. Phoebe Chong. Myung Ja Chun. Kam Yan Chung. Glenn William Cleaver. Laura Michelle Clotworthy. Anton Gavin Cobcroft. Jesse Robert Cogan. Paula Roberta Cohn. Panika Garin Cortez. Georgia Jean Coit. Stephanie Renata Craig, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Irene Kui. Shane Christopher Dalton. Yeah. Trisha Ann D'Souza. Vivian Edward Diaz. Zeren Ding. Charles Philip Michael Don. Christopher Calvin Drake. Rupert Peter Owens Drysdale. Wei Du. Yu Hang Du. Nicole Elizabeth Edgar. Zane Ejaz. Sarah Ain Elder. Hamish John Ronald Ellis. Benjamin McGregor Nolan Elmsley. Laura Margaret English. Rizan Ali Eskeri. Cheng Fang. Senior Scholar Commerce, Ling Fang. Rose Fan. Jane Otovale Fasa Balu. Jonathan Sterling Fellett. Thomas Soani Fizahoy. Stephen Lee Flavel. Robert Nelson James Fletcher, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Rebecca Louise Foley. Sebastian Simon Follis. Catherine Olivia Fonseca. Kay Lin Fu. Mitchell Douglas Foster. Nicholas Joseph Francis. Stace John Freer. Benjamin Jonas Friedlander. Arin Jordan Frost. Kendrick Yook Soon Fong. C.Y. Karen Fung. Samuel Ross Galloway. Yimeng Gao. Luke Xavier Gardner. Meghna Garg. Leisha Dawn Gent. Alice Victoria Winifred Gerbic, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Gabriel Esther Gillard. Olga Gladicheva. Rebecca Sarah Gooch. Carl Robert Gorey. Krish Kunal Gulsai. Nikhil Krishant Gunda. Angela Aniata Grant. Stephanie Suzanne Grapangiza. Alastair Jeffrey Green. Sebastian Dennis Courtney Green, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Claire Julia Greenhill. Aditi Grover, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Meryl Narendra Gulabdas. Benedict Francis Hager. Sana Hamade. Seonghun Han. Ayati Hariharan. Senior Scholar Commerce, Rachel Ann Harker. Vanita Hakasan. Ha Sahiba, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Alice Rose Harwood. Wai Ming He. Peter James Hemmingson. Natalie Ann Henderson, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Sansom Kiyum Nyop King. Matthew James Hennepoff. Trent Gregory Hicks. Irina Hillebrandt. Gary Jason Hill. Johan Ross Hillman. Kevin Hong Xiong Ho. Gavin Hobbs. Vincent James Hockenhull. Laura Kate Holyoke. Sung Jun Hong. Bowen Po Yuan Shao. Ying Hu. Mike Huang. Yifeng Huang. Jonathan Oscar Huber, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Isti Hudaya. Sung Kyu Huang. Reese Michael Jack. Hannah Zhang. Simon John Jarman. Renesh Jaram, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Aditi Jarath. Jing Jing Ji. Yang Ji. Ji Jin Jiang. Angela Zhou. Andrew Nicholas Johnson. Brittany Amber Johnston. Ropin Dajot. Scott Justice. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint. Christopher Benjamin Hugh Adamson and a Bachelor of Arts. Ahmed Saab Abdul Sahib Al Mokhtar and a Bachelor of Science. Brooke Aston and a Bachelor of Laws. Cole Peter Atkinson and a Bachelor of Property. Lauren Elizabeth Beagley and a Bachelor of Arts. Ravindjit Kaur Bopari and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts, Senior Scholar Commerce, Julie Jalen Xiao and a Bachelor of Arts. Mai Bianco Castillo Canillo and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts, Anan Emily Chai, and a Bachelor of Arts. Maru Chandra, and a Bachelor of Arts. Mingzhong Chia, and a Bachelor of Arts. Queenie Wai Chow Chek, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Science, Lex Yi Chen, and a Bachelor of Science. Pei Wen Chen, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Karen Kaman Cheng, and a Bachelor of Science. Jade Wei Cheung, and a Bachelor of Arts. Laura Elizabeth Wern Yichia and a Bachelor of Arts. Alex Chi Kit Chu and a Bachelor of Arts. Lauren Teresa Collins and a Bachelor of Property. Stefan Moritz Rogan Cornell and a Bachelor of Arts. Heidi Margaret Croft and a Bachelor of Arts. Virginia Hope Joy Dale, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Anna Simona Dragulescu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Christina Nancy Allen Dunn, and a Bachelor of Property. Senior Scholar Arts, Senior Scholar Commerce, Marco Oikster, and a Bachelor of Arts. Laura Grace Fitzpatrick, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Yaji Fu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jasmine Po Young Fung, and a Bachelor of Property. Shubi Garg, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Olivia Rachel Gibbons, and a Bachelor of Arts. Zane Vincent Gibbs, and a Bachelor of Arts. Hannah Joy Going, and a Bachelor of Arts. Juliet Wentworth Greer, and a Bachelor of Property. Senior Scholar Commerce, Senior Scholar Science, Suzanne Brooke Hayden, and a Bachelor of Science. Jin Kyung Han, and a Bachelor of Science. Anna Elizabeth Wilson Harley, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Emily Louise Harris, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jordan Nicholas Hills, and a Bachelor of Science. Wingsy Jessica Ho, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lauren Michelle Honeycomb, and a Bachelor of Arts. Angie Huang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Kao Ying, Angela Hui, and a Bachelor of Arts. Zoe Rachel Hunt, and a Bachelor of Arts. Natalie Claire Inslee, and a Bachelor of Arts. Divya Jajendra Nath, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jody Patrick Thomas Johnston, and a Bachelor of Property. Postgraduate Diploma in Business. Charlotte Maria, Arts and Human Resource Management. Jane Barbara Banfield in Human Resource Management. Christopher John Boyle in Administration. Luke John Clancy in Administration. Angela Marie Clark in Administration. Raymond Allen Coventry in Administration. Adi Malika Marama Dilanamati in Administration. Sukanya Amal Kanti Dutta in Administration. Terry England in Operations Management. Alfred Mark Foster in Administration. Clint Dean Fush in Administration. Jin Gao in Human Resource Management. Helena Jane Gibson in Administration. Joanne Marie Gillespie in Human Resource Management. Peter Michael Robert Hall in Human Resource Management. Jared Gregory Harris in Administration. Prudence Elizabeth Hawkes in Human Resource Management. Matthew Paul Hawkins in Human Resource Management. Darren Allen Haywood in Administration. Sarah Louise Hazlett in Human Resource Management. Goyan Ivanoshki in Administration. Lee Deanne Knight in Human Resource Management. Paula Faliaupolu Maiau in Administration. Kumaran Mangalakuma in Administration. Kelly Marie Meekins in Human Resource Management. Bonard Metahisa in Administration. Richard John Neat in Human Resource Management. Andrew Crichton Nelson in Supply Chain Management. Malcolm O'Connell in Administration. Tanya Rona Rochelle Parangi in Administration. Emma May Parker in Human Resource Management. Bhavna Prentice in Administration. Ben Joseph Richardson in Health Management. Sharon Poonam Shah in Administration. Christine Francis Smith in Administration. Jane Glenburn Spears in Human Resource Management. Vicky Kimberly Spencer in Human Resource Management. Julia Rachel Stace in Human Resource Management. Bata Stoos-Greig in Human Resource Management. Angela Chershin Tai in Administration. Victoria Tattersfield in Administration. Claire Helen Elizabeth Thorne in Administration. Pa'ea Tui in Human Resource Management. Grant William Wardle in Administration. Jeffrey Haig White in Human Resource Management. Jason Tarpine Wilson in Supply Chain Management. Majid Zahua in Administration. Rui Zhong in Operations Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Distinction, Ella Watson in Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Merit, Lucy Laura Caitlin Clark in International Business. Junqiao Li in Information Systems. Sharina Manisha Patel in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce, Gursajan Singh in Management. Ji Yao in Operations and Supply Chain Management.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Natasha Port on oboe, accompanied by Rosemary Barnes on piano, will now perform Bassoon Concerto in F Major by Carl Maria von Weber. It's not that often that we have the pleasure of hearing the oboe at graduation, and you're reminded on what an interesting instrument it is. And it was beautifully accompanied, of course, Rosemary on the piano, emphatically but not overpowering. Can I ask everyone to show their appreciation again? Thank you. Every year we have memorable performances by our students, and if you would like to hear further performances, all graduates and their families are invited to the graduation concert, which is to be held at 7:30 p.m. this Saturday in the Town Hall. By the authority vested in me, by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Business and Economics have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitred, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Elena Bain-Sianu in Marketing. Prathik Balakrishna in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jeremy Paul Beckham in Commercial Law. Kristen Victoria Bouchier in Marketing. Suzanne Francis Emma Bowerman, Accounting. University Graduate Scholar, Chelsea Norma Nahuia Boblitz, and a Bachelor of Commerce. University Graduate Scholar, Rory Paul Bunker, Economics. Christopher Allen Stewart Bunning, Finance, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jennifer Liu Chen in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Claire Pixian Cho in Marketing. Charlene Sarita Correa in Commercial Law. University Graduate Scholar, Senior Scholar Accounting, Matthew James Davis in Accounting with a Bachelor of Commerce. Paul Edward Dixon, Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. And a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Dylan John Ford in Marketing. University Graduate Scholar, Cameron Mark Fraser, Accounting. Zach Hyde in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Charlotte Tace Horton in Management and a Bachelor of Arts and a Bachelor of Commerce conjoint. Stephen James Hoskins in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Suzanne Claire Ainsworth in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Michelle Winifred Challoner in Commercial Law. Yanshuan Chen in Accounting. James Charles Anthony Cooper, Commercial Law. Emma Margaret Fenton, Commercial Law. Sutaisa Tupo Valila Fuveo in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Yongyan Guo, Accounting. Joel John in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Weng Loon Chan in Commercial Law. To the degree of Master of Business Administration, Stephen Eric Becker and a Postgraduate Diploma in Business in Administration. Kerry Yvette Boyell. Amit Kumar Dirajlal Bhattadra. Carl Adam Brooks and a Postgraduate Diploma in Administration. Paul Matthew Bunbury. Mike Chineka. Claire Marie Christie. Ranadeep Datta. Carleen Julia Davey. Craig William Dennis. Alicia Patricia Donald. Mark Bernard Godineau. Rack Tim Halder. Megan Hall. James Daniel Hodgson. James Fall Littlejohn. Ying Liu, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Business and Administration. Richard David Long. Brendan Grant Main, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Business and Administration. Brendan Grant Main, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Business Administration. My apologies. Christopher James McClement. Kirsten Lisa McDonald. Stacey Roger McIntosh. Robert Allen Michael. Mirza Wajahat Ali Beg. Wendy Lee Mitchell. Teresa Marie Monahan. Dawson Mahurangi Mutu. Shivam Rajan Naidu. Jun Siok Park. Jan Leon Raver. Natika Priya Sharma. Aaron Peter Slebos, and a postgraduate diploma in business and administration. Robert Nelson Spears. Rosalind Helen Stewart. Helga Daniel Wahl. Philip Anthony Verissimo. Timothy Hayden Walker. Bradford Todd Wheatley. Stephen Mark White, and a postgraduate diploma in business and administration. Baron Quinton Wong. Timothy Craig Woods. Wei Jung. To the degree of Master of Commerce with First Class Honours, Mark Christopher Andrew Shulvers in Management. Young Hun Ji in Management and a Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Merit in Management. Fang Xing Liu in Information Systems and a Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Distinction in Information Systems. Helen Liu, Accounting. Tony Kwok Luen So, Economics. Amanda Rachel Sterling, Management. Wei Ning Tan, Information Systems. Song Wong, Economics. Lin Wong in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division in Economics. Ming Han Wu, Information Systems. Liu Yu, Accounting. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours First Division, Rachel Whitney Rose Cocker in Management and a Postgraduate Diploma with Merit in Management. Emma Elizabeth Gordon in Management. Darlene Kelly, Management. Hee Soon Kim in Management. Denithi Hassan Razi Paranagama in International Business. Aina Frederica Tate, Management. Brigitte Vassana in Management. Bonita Su Wai Yun, Marketing. To the degree of Master of International Business with First Class Honours, Tanmay Mittal. Joanna Birchman Nonato. Konstantin Silitsky. Thomas Edward Warden. to the degree of Master of International Business with Second Class Honours First Division, Christina Anaid Alvarado Yuseki. Juan Chen. Ning Ding. Li Wenji. David Jonathan Lau. Wenda Lemos Martins. Tawanda Elijah Munure. Margaret Chan Chui Nau. Needham Truter. Li Yan Wang. Rowan Jean Waterworth. Jing Zhao. To the degree of Master of International Business, Second Class Honours, Second Division, Hu Feifei. Nerushan Jagannathan. Sanjit Kaushal. Shankar Raghunathan Malavali. Pankti Pradeep Ravani. Jingyao Wang. Ping Zhang. To the degree of Master of International Business, Olga Lusenko. To the degree of Master of Management, Yi Peng. Ativa Pearl Willemu. To the degree of Master of Management, Mark Keogh Bright. Philip John Dobson. Robin June Hill. Darren Noel Peter Mendonca.
I now call upon a Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Professor Ian Martin, to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Benjamin Philippe Pfaff in Management. Benjamin investigated why individuals become involved in creating innovative ventures, how these ventures become established in markets, and how they are sustained giving emerging competition. Based on a study of 17 innovative New Zealand businesses, his findings shed light on the individual opportunity nexus perspective of entrepreneurship and are of use to practitioners. Antje Fiedler in Management, University Doctoral Scholar. Antje's research showed that German airports adopted certain neoliberal practices and norms as a response to a changing institutional environment. Lala Harian Ardakani in Information Systems, University Doctoral Scholar. Given a given set of cities and the cost of travel between each pair of them, the travelling salesman problem, or TSP for short, is to find the least cost tour visiting all of the cities and returning to the home city. Though the problem is easy to state, the TSP is one of the most intensely studied problems in computer science, and yet no efficient solution method is known for the general case. Lala developed methods for the solution of the travelling salesman problem based on a compact formulation of the problem. She performed computational experiments to further support the theoretical characteristics of this formulation. Helen Yang Huang in Economics, University Doctoral Scholar. Helen provided one of the first empirical studies of the impact of quality of service regulations on electricity distribution networks in the United Kingdom and New Zealand. Nan Jiang in Economics, University Doctoral Scholar. Nan investigated the efficiency of New Zealand dairy farming to provide estimates of its ability to adjust to possible cost increases arising from the emissions trading scheme. Stephen Edward Jollins in Accounting, University Doctoral Scholar. Stephen investigated the link between management control systems and sustainability with a view to better understanding how economic organisations approach this important issue. And, in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma.
As you would expect, the university places great importance on teaching, and it recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in particular aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify truly superior achievement. An award for excellence in innovation in teaching has been made to Ms. Angela Liu in the Department of Accounting and Finance within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Kenny Chan, to read the citation for Ms. Angela Liu.
Angela's enthusiastic, innovative, and effective teaching has made a significant contribution to teaching in the Accounting Information Systems class. Angela showed an amazing level of commitment to improving student success in a topic that's usually pretty difficult for students. I was impressed by her enthusiastic approach and the large amount of time she invested to developing resources to enhance learning. She introduced a comprehensive range of e-learning resources. Her teaching methods are always very clear, relevant, and interesting. And we particularly enjoyed her pre-recorded computer laboratory workshop exercises with audio narrated instructions and explanations to guide students step by step through each problem. In particular, her students enjoyed the flying lessons PowerPoint slides. These were animated diagrams with voice-over narration that ran through each transaction cycle one step at a time. Angela also introduced regular FAQ email announcements to explain to students common issues raised by the class. And Angela didn't just develop these resources. She collected data on how often students were using the recorded lectures, workshops, and e-tutorials so that she could analyze which ones were most effective and continue to improve the course. Angela's innovations have resulted in the class being extremely happy with the course and have taken away the risk and frustration over administrative and computer literacy issues. We are able to put all of our energy into understanding the course content. I believe that Angela deserves this award because she has helped students appreciate accounting and to learn from a different perspective. Angela.
On behalf of the university, I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And this would be the perfect opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Maori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programs.